My boy enjoys riding a scooter every day. Sometimes I need to warn him because he goes too far on his own. Because my boy is still too young, he needs someone who can look after him always. If my child has an ankle device I made with UWB, I know the physical distance between me and my child, so I want to warn him based on the distance away. There can be several ways to notify of a warning, and the most commonly used method is making some sound. So I'm trying to up a sound through the Max 98357 and a small speaker. In my devices, the ankle device doesn't have a display, so I need a way to tell about the current device status. When the connection is established, the voice file called connected is played, and in the Apache case, the voice file called disconnected is played. It's very intuitive. A total of 4 audio files were prepared, 2 files for connections and 2 files for the distance. If the distance between the tag and the anchor is more than 10 meters, this sound is output.
Don't go too far.
If it's more than 20 meters away, you will hear this sound. All audio files were created by my iPhone, and the sampling rate is 44.1 kHz and the bit per sample is 16 bits. The I2S audio library I'm using doesn't support 32 bits, so this is the maximum sound quality, I guess. The project code can be downloaded via the video description below. The code works very simply, only the audio part has been added to the existing anchor example code. Using this ESP32 audio I2S library, you can not only play MP3 and WAV files but also internet audio. This is a very useful library. It looks like the audio library doesn't support Reader FS yet, so the audio files were saved inside the ESP32 through SPI FFS in advance. Whenever its callback function is called, the corresponding audio file is played. Also, depending on the distance, the audio is played at an interval of about 10 seconds. If there is a no interval, playback continues, so it's played only once of every 10 seconds if it's over 10 meters. One thing I need to mention is interrupt service routines from DW1000 and audio for I2S crash when playing wrong audio. I tried to separate this part by task, but it didn't work properly. So I will update it again later through another project. Thanks for your understanding. I tested outside but couldn't get the good result. The speaker is too small, so barely hear the sound. For outdoor use, we need to use a speaker with a larger output. Or there is a way to use a mobile phone. It will be a better project when the small hardware that can be connected to the mobile phone is completed. I will continue to update. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.